The sports and arts facilities at many independent schools and elsewhere across Britain are outstanding. But for much of the year, they are underused. All over the country, there are children who can benefit from access to these facilities. Children with physical and mental disabilities. Children who are excluded or marginalised. Children who are at risk.
If we wasn't here, I would be, don't know, I'd probably be doing nothing, sitting around doing nothing.
I'd be normally just sitting at home, just playing around, just picking up clothes, playing outside.
I can't learn right, you know. I'm slow on my reading and learning. I get bored when I'm stuck at home and in my room. And then I go and play. Or I go and destroy something.
Mum said it was really good for us, because normally I'll be being naughty or something, doing something that I'll get in trouble.
Greenhouse projects bring together underused facilities and the children who will benefit from them.
Look, smile, you're on candy camera.
The kids have benefited from the fact that we've got so much facilities. The Greenhouse Schools project have just, you know, up for coaches that they wouldn't normally meet. In what's the name, Darren, who is the head coach here, is from the Dream Team off Sky Television. And, you know, they wouldn't get to meet somebody like that if he wasn't here coaching the children. And the football facilities, children just want to play football. Girls, trampolining, gymnast. And it gives them a chance to do something they wouldn't normally be able to do.
All of my friends know I'm doing it. So a lot of the guys at Dream Team actually came down in the Easter week. They came down and signed loads of stuff, met the kids, so it was good for the kids. You all right? I can't move. I'm all taped up.
Yeah, what's up?
How are you, mate? You all right?
Yeah, fine.
Say hello to the camera.
Hi.
BBC News recently highlighted the positive effects we are having on local communities and children.
They're not hanging around the street, so they're not getting involved in crime, or, you know, they're not becoming victims of crime. They're in a safe environment, they're learning, they're having fun, and our crime rates are definitely affected because they're greatly reduced throughout the whole period.
Its founders say private schools have been so enthusiastic they're actually turning schools away for lack of money.
I think what we're doing is probably one of the most cost-effective crime, education and health policies around. And our hope is, and a large part of this, is that we can enthuse these children to take part in these activities long term, not just for the 2 weeks that they're here.
The children's health and education benefit, both in the short term and in the long term. They're off the streets and out of their homes, learning teamwork and new skills, making new friends, giving them new ambition and hope.
The children who come on these sorts of courses, the children who come in and are taught by first-class coaches, get a chance to work together, are learning skills which they might otherwise not get an opportunity to acquire. They're learning responsibility, they're learning how to work in a team, they're learning things which are going to benefit the whole of their education as adults, not just as children.
I was one of these underprivileged kids. I didn't have the chance to go to a site and play football and receive coaching, so maybe that's why I feel so strongly and that's why I get so much fun, because I'm giving something back. To kids within this area who maybe don't have the chance to do it, to come out and play football in a safe environment, keeps them off the estate.
Parents and carers benefit greatly too, both from the respite and from the knowledge that their children are involved in constructive activity.
I'm very impressed by these two people actually getting the children working the way they are.
Oh, I think it's fantastic. It's given a lot of our special needs children the opportunity to join in the sports which they would never have the chance to do.
Pupils who volunteer from participating schools also benefit.
We're so lucky to have such great facilities here that it's only right kind of to share them with everyone else. And I think I want to work with kids in the future. So it's like getting on the ladder, working with children. It makes me feel wonderful to be able to help them.
Hello! Hello!
children who are fortunate enough to go to a greenhouse project find it enjoyable, exciting and enriching.
This is great about this greenhouse hall because it's quite big and it got things that you could enjoy doing. I really like it because then we got a trampoline I really am like jumping on.
It's fine because in this school I don't usually go on lots of trips. And she said, and she wrote the letter and gave it to my, I gave it to my teacher. And then she gave it and she let me come here.
My favourite thing is I like acting a lot here and I like dancing, I like anything. And also I like the staff and Dean and the other children. I think they're really nice friends and I like them a lot.
Oh, he really loved it. He really enjoyed drama and theatre. He's really found, he was really interested to come to the course and he's really brilliant.
No, I haven't done drama before. Yeah, it was good. I didn't think I'd be able to do it.
Thank you!
I think Queen of House is my top favourite, I think. And I like it a lot.
You have a nice time.
Yeah!
As a result of our success, we are now being offered all sorts of exciting facilities. To take advantage of these, we urgently need more funding. We could help so many more children.
Bye. Bye-bye. Bye-bye.
Pleasure.
Have fun. And you have fun too. And you.
Thank you.
And bye-bye to you.
Okay, see
ya.
Thanks
bye.
A lot. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Thank you. Pleasure. Bye-bye. Bye-bye.
I believe that children are our future. Teach them well and let them lead the way. Show them all the beauty they possess inside. Give them a sense of pride to make it easier. Let the children's laughter lead you to a love.